Where are we supposed to take a shower?
Go get your money back. I'm not playing with you. I'm not. It's not funny. I'm calling John. No, because I'm not playing with you. I can't be living like this. I have a husband. It's not funny. Stop fucking laughing.
No, this is not funny. But it's funny because I spent $558 on this fucking room.
Everybody, I am Diva Mazel, and this is my channel. And today we are going to be doing sleeping at the worst rated hotel in New York City by accident. As you guys know, I decided to go to BeautyCon New York this year, which was a complete fucking flop. But that's not the point of this video. I already did that. If you want to know how my experience went, check the eye up above on whichever side it's on. Not only was the trip trash, okay, not only was BeautyCon trash, but my hotel room was trash too. Now, I must completely say it is my fault for not completely checking the reviews, and it is also my fault for not completely reading the description of this place, okay? I ended up renting the Grand NYC Hotel in New York. Apparently, it's one of those hotels that are like community bathrooms. I heard that there was some rooms that had like a private bathroom, but I ended up booking a hotel on a floor that had a community bathroom. I kid y'all not, I did not on purpose book this goddamn thing knowing that. If I knew it was a community bathroom, I would have never booked it. The only reason I realized how bad the hotel was literally when I was in the Uber on my way to the hotel.
Hopefully this hotel room's nice, because if it's not, it's gonna be a really good story time.
If it's not, I'm going home.
No, you're not.
Sir, when you take us to the hotel, wait for me 2 minutes. If it's not good, I'm coming back home.
I think it's gonna be...
No. Sir, please. I'll let you know. I'll give you 5 stars. Plus 2.
First of all, I really think it's gonna be fine.
Yeah, okay.
I think it's gonna be fine.
So you haven't been to this area she going to? No. You know what that mean? That's garbage.
Don't do that. I think it might, you know what, let's look up the reviews now. Cause I could've swore I did check the reviews.
That means it's garbage.
Don't do that.
He doesn't even know about it. What are you talking about?
That don't mean, that New York is huge.
Yeah, when it's huge, everybody know the good places.
Shut up.
Listen, I watch Coming to America a lot. Prince Hakeem stayed at the Waldorf Astoria. I'm sure they have rooms there. You could have got me in there, okay? So, it's 2 stars. Don't play with me.
Yeah. I could have, but the reviews were good.
Lamed. What the, sir? Can you cancel this room?
No!
I'm not playing with, I asked you, did you see the
I did, the but review? I think the reviews were like directly on the site. Those were the ones I saw.
Drop me off at the Waldorf.
Oh my God.
On Google, it was a 2.7. When I was looking at it somewhere else, it was like a 2.6. So, let's see. Nice rooms, a bit pricey, but excellent service and decor. Small and smelly place was shocked the first place. I guess they meant to say first sight. Bitch, I was shocked too. Okay, pictures in the website showed standard size rooms and bathroom, but it was so small that it was hard to move in either of them. No closet available. I didn't like that you have to share bathrooms and they were dirty and stink. They didn't have soap in the rooms. It was a bed in the floor. What the fuck? A bed in the floor. Nobody cleaned the room or give us clean towels. The people that lived there made so much noise. There was no AC. I almost could not sleep because of the noise, and they were slamming the doors. Okay. It's funny, they actually replied to this. Dear guests, we are sorry that you were not fully satisfied with your reservation. However, with all due respect, all your comments are not correct. We are not hotel. We are short-term apartment residential. If you are looking to have everyday cleaning, you should have reserved in one of the hotels in the area that are 3 to 8 times more than us.
On your second complaint, please know all of our 16 common bathrooms are fully renovated in 2018 and they are designer bathrooms and get cleaned 4 times a day. 3, in regards to your complaint about AC, we are very surprised with this comment. While every day outside temperature is below freezing, you are asking for AC. And finally, please note that your reservation was not in a single family home. It was in a large building in a busy town on a Manhattan, and of course, there are always some noise. On the hallways, but not slamming doors. Again, thank you for staying with us. Kind regards. And this was January 25th, 2019. These motherfuckers about rude as fuck, y'all. Like, I'm telling you, this has to be the same bitch that I talked on the phone with. Okay, I'll get into that. That was just rude. All right, next one. Very, very poor indeed. The building picture on Expedia isn't the picture on the actual rundown property. Located just next door to the liquor store, front desk will not allow you to see the room. Documents to sign stating that the room may not be as pictured as described, no amenities, no refund. Did I sign that? You will be asked for your credit card, but you will then be asked to pay any taxes, fees, etc. in cash only, so you have no recourse. Oh, they didn't do that to me. Rude folks, room 508 isn't double twin advertised, but an aluminum frame bunk bed. The bathroom is very tiny, may actually be converted clothes closet. The shower has a broken shelf, so there's no place for your soap, etc. Temp control by an old tiny box AC unit, too small, too poor to work properly. Radiator for heat, too hot, and no knob to control. Front desk, not employees, will not assist manager, is unavailable. Wi-Fi not in room and broken in lobby. Broken TV, no paint, broken furniture in lobby, no water, no coffee, none available. Entire building in despair. Manager unannounced to room, rude, resolved nothing, told us no amenities, go to the plaza. Front desk not 24/7 as advertised. No one at the front desk to check out the $30 fee key if not left with the front desk security. Horrible place. And this is the response from management. Yo, these niggas funny as hell. Dear guests, unfortunately, all the complaints that you made are absolutely false and not correct. Please allow us to explain. 1, the documents that you have been asked to sign is for the protection of the guests to make sure all of our guests who arrive are the one who made the reservation. They are guests. They are our guests and they are the right person to get access to our property. 2, in regards to your problem to pay the city tax, we would like to inform you the city tax is $3.5 per day, was not collected by your primary agency, and has been clearly stated in every reservation paid. This has to be paid upon arrival. 3, in regards to your other problem for showing your credit card, the credit card was requested like any other accommodations to be on file in case any damage to the property and will not be used for any other reason. 4, all of our rooms constantly checked by our maintenance group to make sure there will be no problem or damage items in the room. We deliver all of our rooms in a perfect condition. 5, we do have Wi-Fi and actually it is available for all our guests free of charge. 6, our rooms have the most expensive TV. Woo! And they are all checked to make sure that they are working perfectly, and unfortunately you damaged the TV and did not want to take responsibility of your action. 7, all of our rooms have kitchenette with ref stove, sink, dishes, silverware, cups, pots, pans, electric kettle, and if you expect to have more, we do not understand what more can be delivered. Finally, unfortunately, you damaged a lot of items in the room and did not even provide your credit card and still giving all these nonsense accusation and false information. Even the other accommodations that you stayed with them before, we agreed with us that they do not want to welcome to reserve a room for you anymore. Regards. Why didn't I see these? Now, I booked this shit on booking.com. These reviews are on Expedia. Son, I'm fucking flabbergasted. Yeah! This is so fucking funny. I think that's enough. That's enough to tell y'all that this place was just a hot ass fucking mess. This place really was not as pictured. It was not what I expected at all. Like, and this is just Expedia. So we get there. There's fucking security surveillance footage in the fucking lobby. It's not even really a lobby. There's just a security guard
sitting there giving you your keys and telling you to sign shit. We go through the hallways, and I'm just like, okay, I fucked up.
Okay.
Found it.
So we're in here, and waiting for the elevator. They gave me the key thing. It's actually not that bad.
First of all, I ain't never seen a motel that's an apartment too. You see people getting messages. I would not want to live here.
No, it's an apartment hotel.
What the hell is an apartment hotel? It's not Germany.
It's New York. I'm trying to remain optimistic about this right now.
Remain, because I ain't dead. They got like 10 cameras on big screens. What that mean? That don't make me feel scared.
Shut up. Just press the damn button.
That don't make me feel safe at all.
Don't you feel safe with cameras around?
On big screens? What that mean? You have to see it that long?
Honestly, what became a BeautyCon vlog is about to be staying at the worst rated hotel in New York.
Got it.
Yeah, this elevator is kind of grungy.
Wow.
Y'all.
You hear that?
Yeah, this shit's squeaking, guys. Yo, fuck. Alright, so we about to walk into the. What the fuck? Son, no, I'm scared.
First of all, get off the bed.
What the fuck?
Welcome to the penitentiary.
Yo, what the fuck?
I'm not a tall person. Come on.
Oh my god. Oh, there's someone humming, guys, and I'm scared. Oh my god. Terrified.
Once you done seeing with my back,
I fucked up. We go in the elevator. I'm like, I fucked up. So we get in there. We get to the floor and we're just like, bro, like this can't be it. So we open the door. First of all, from the pictures I saw, it wasn't the same. Okay, I was expecting the pictures I saw, and I was also expecting like a bunk bed, because I'm sure there was a bunk bed in the pictures when I booked. It was supposed to be three of us. It was me, Desi, and Sandia. It was only two beds. One bed was slightly bigger, but there's no way two people were sleeping on that motherfucking bed. The room didn't look the same at all. It was just, guys, oh my god.
All right. Okay. There is no tap, there's one lock. Okay. Am I just being stupid?
Stop playing games.
I'm not.
What the hell?
Yo, I don't have time for this.
Sir. Hold on. Try to open it.
Maybe I gotta open it like I'm from the hood.
What does that mean? No. The thing clicking over.
It's clicking.
You hear it unlocked. It won't even twist.
Oh.
Get one undone.
Didn't I ask for, where's, no. Why is there only two beds here?
Unlock it first, because I'm not sitting in this little apartment.
What the fuck is this? But we were supposed to have a.
Have you been to a hotel before?
Listen. Wait.
Okay. This is the entire room.
How? Wait, where are you supposed to shower?
Hold on. playing with you. Can't be living like this. I have a husband. It's not funny. Stop fucking laughing.
No, this is not funny. But it's funny because I spent $558 on this fucking room.
This shit was funny to me. I'm telling y'all that right now. This shit was funny. It was hilarious. Until I realized there was no fucking bathroom. That's when I was like, oh, hell no. Cut. Okay? And I just gotta say, I paid $558 for this shit, I think. This shit was not worth no $558. Like, y'all, like, my head was fucking spinning.
Not their shoes outside their door. This is just unfucking believable. Unfucking believable. Niggas about to drop hella bread on a new hotel though. Just wait on it, cause we're not sleeping here with no fucking community showers. Did I show y'all the community showers? Hold up. Wait.
Y'all, this shit not even clean. Did not want to sleep there. First of all, I did not want to take no shower in no community shower. Like, the fuck? I already went through that hell in college. I am not going through that hell after I paid $558 for literally like 3 nights. The amount of stress that I was. The amount of stress. So at this point, we are calling hotels, trying to figure out like where could we go for tonight, for the rest of this trip. Like, what we gonna do? How we gonna do it? What we gonna do? Like, what are we doing? Like, wagwan. Everywhere is coming like $600, $700, $800. We're just like, bro. Oh. I was like, you know what? Let me just go, you know, to the bank real quick, get some money. Cause like the way my bank accounts were set up at the time, like I had money everywhere. So I had to like take money from one bank account to put to another bank account because fucking Capital One server was down. So it was ridiculous. So since I had to book a whole nother hotel after spending like $500 something, we walked to the bank and literally, apparently there's a fuck ton of hotels in New York. Literally we walked into every single hotel on the way there. So we stumbled upon this one hotel, amazing hotel. It's called the Walcott. Shout out to y'all. Y'all are amazing. This black brother hooked us up. Okay, this nigga was like, yeah, you know, if you guys stay from tonight until Monday, which was like Friday, right? It was Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and I would leave Monday morning. He's like, yeah, that'll be $690. I'm just like, at this point, I gave up. I was like, you know what? We're just not gonna find a hotel. But then he saw how stressed we were. And he was like, you know what? Since y'all some sisters, and I see y'all, what y'all went through, I do it for $400. I think it was like $440. I was like, bless your heart. Thank you. Thank you.
I appreciate that.
Bless your heart, y'all. I was so fucking stressed. So in total, I paid almost $1,000. Like,
what happened to the other hotel? Did y'all get a refund?
No. The nigga refused to give me a refund and put me on the phone with the owner who also refused to give me a refund, okay? And this bitch was incredibly fucking rude.
We didn't know. And I thought it was going to
Hello, I'd like to know what the process would be to like not stay here and get like partial refund. I'm non-refundable. So there's nothing if I didn't stay the whole time. Alright, so there's nothing you could do. Okay, so there's no
refund. The room said there was gonna be a 20, what do you call those bunk beds?
Yeah, honestly, this was like false advertising.
We weren't told this was gonna be a community bathroom.
It's okay, I'll be contacting my baby.
Thank you.
It's okay. Booking.com. All right, so, ma'am, it's okay. I'll be going to my bank and getting a refund.
Yeah,
thank you.
We didn't make this purchase.
All right. Okay.
This is not the purchase we made.
Okay. You do not want to welcome me. Okay.
We don't
want to
stay here.
You'll see your tape on YouTube. Goodbye.
What? Right. Okay.
She was like, oh, why don't you want to stay at the hotel? I was like, honestly, this is not as described. Like, I understand the community bathroom thing. Maybe I didn't read that right, but the room does not look anywhere near what was described. The bathroom isn't clean at all. And overall, it just doesn't look like the pictures. It's just not, like, no. And plus, there's no reason why I didn't stay here the whole time and y'all should be holding my money. Like, I want to leave today. She's like, well, if you leave, that's your choice. But we can't give you your money back. And I'm like, why can't you give me my money back? Like, I don't understand. Like, I'm not staying here, like, at all. And she's like, well, we can't give you a refund. I was like, that's nice. I'm going to be going to my bank and I'm going to be getting a refund. She goes, oh, well, if you're going to go that route, then we don't want to welcome you here. Bitch, I don't want to stay here. What are you talking about? Nah, bro. I'm like, all right, bitch. Good night. Somebody gonna roll me my money back. So, I contacted booking.com, and they're doing an investigation, which is ridiculous. And if they don't give me a refund, I'm definitely getting a refund from my bank. I don't give a fuck. Somebody running me my motherfucking money back. Somebody's giving me my money back because I didn't even fucking stay there. It's ridiculous. And I booked a whole nother hotel. Like, honestly, that was very stressful, okay? It was a very stressful experience. I'm highly upset that, like, I had to stay there for, like, even 2 hours. Literally, I only stayed there for 2 hours. I didn't stay there for long at all, so I think I'm entitled to my money back, to be completely honest with you. Like, run me my shit. It's not that fucking serious. Did not stay the whole time. I had to fucking go to a whole nother place because that shit was just disgusting. And the new place was nice. He hooked us up with a bigger suite. It was like 2 beds in one room and then 1 bed in another room. And there was 2 TVs in there. It was super nice. Like, shout out to the Walcott. If y'all ever need a hotel to go to the Walcott, New York, okay?
We just got hooked up. We got complimentary drinks, cuz. This hotel's clutch. Say he gave us a bigger room. Let's see, guys.
I already don't know how to act. All right. I'm about to act all the way the fuck up. I really need to sit down.
All right. Okay. So, new hotel room. It has a very, like, old school type of vibe situation going with it. It's very cute. Hmm.
Yes. Oh my god.
Oh shit. Okay, cuz.
Oh my god.
Alright.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Oh my god.
Now, okay, this is cute.
Oh my god, thank you.
We got a bathroom. Oh, this is super small.
It don't matter.
But
it's
a bathroom.
It's in here.
It is now 7:57, as y'all can see on the motherfucking clock. Okay, I like this a lot. Got a hotel room or whatever. Paid $440 for this one because the nigga gave us a hookup. No, it was $440 and some change.
I thought it was $441.
He was nice. He didn't round it to the nearest dollar. But honestly, if y'all know anything about New York, y'all would know that the fucking prices for hotels are insane. Every hotel we called up was literally trying to charge me like $600, like $50 and up, like $650, $690 type shit. And this man gave us a nice ass discount. I don't even think he charged us a deposit at all. Y'all, I'm forever grateful. Make sure y'all come to this hotel. I'm gonna leave all the information down in the description. Man, super nice. He hooked us up. I'm sure he saw our struggle, okay? He saw what we was going through and he helped us out. Like, y'all, I'm forever grateful. But I'm definitely about to call Capital One up and tell them to run me my motherfucking money back because this hotel owner was rude as fuck at the other place. Like, as y'all heard, like, I was being mad fucking calm. Like, I wasn't even being rude with her. I wasn't like,
oh, da da. I was like, you know, is there anything you do? Da da da. She's just like, no refunds. Like, bitch. I'm like, okay, well, I'm gonna be going to my bank and I'll get my money back that way, man. She's like, well, if you want to go that way, then we don't want to welcome you. Like, huh?
It is pretty expensive, though. Thank God I got the hookup. It is pretty expensive, but it's really nice. It has a very old school-esque vibe. It was built in like early 1900s, like 1904 or something. So it still has a lot of that. It has like the old school chandelier and the carpets, and it's just very like old school glam vibe-ish. I loved it. But yeah, that was the story of how I stayed at the worst rated hotel in New York. Funny thing is, Sandia really thought I did this shit on purpose, guys. She thought that I literally wasted almost $600 on this hotel room to make a fucking video, and honestly, I did not. Like, I swear to God, I did not. This was honestly like me just being ignorant and not doing the research that I should have done ahead of time, just picking the cheapest place. It's clearly my fault, but at the same time, the room is not as advertised. The bathrooms are dirty. The rooms just weren't nice, like, at all. Like, it just, oh God, the hallways were nasty. The elevator was nasty. It was a bad experience overall. I did not do that on purpose.
Oh, that's it for this video. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'ma see y'all next time.